Welcome back to Ultimate General Civil War, here on Serious Gaming. 1863, the Battle of Chancellorsville. Will be quite the bloodbath. I will deploy the 1st Corps in the vanguard, the 2nd Corps in the center, and the 3rd Corps in the rear guard. Together, my army will form up about close to 60,000 troops in total. The Confederate army will form up 52,000 troops. Almost. For 53. Our forces have crossed the western fords of the river and are now marching inside Confederate territory. Our vanguard is marching down U.S. Ford Road. Our main army is approaching from Ellie's Ford Road. The rear guard will arrive from Orange Turnpike. And our vanguard is expected to arrive today, 30th of April, at Chancellorsville Road Junction. We have established our camp at Chancellor's Farm, and tomorrow, when more of our forces arrive, we will advance to meet Lee's army near Fredericksburg. Not gonna happen, I'm afraid. Up to now, we have not met any serious opposition, probably because Lee's army is stretched out too thin. We have spotted enemy movements at the roads ahead of us, but we should be able to repel them easily. Except, Lee is drawing you into a trap. General, we are ready to advance. Our vanguard awaits your command. A few of our forces have already begun marching via River Road. No sight of the enemy there. We must scout and hold the ridge that controls Orange Turnpike, which leads to the town of Fredericksburg. The road which leads to Fredericksburg, Orange Plank Road, must also be secured. It is advice to defend our camp till more troops arrive. The Confederates might attack before we consolidate our forces. Yes, indeed. They may very well do so. And they will. Either way. Nothing to worry about. So, let's just form up and get ready to deal as much damage as we can to the enemy. This deployment doesn't make a whole lick of sense, if I'm quite honest over here. Well, I guess it makes sense if you're gonna fight on the flanks. Anyway. Quite a few troops stationed over here. We want to minimize casualties, at least in the early phases of this particular fight. After that, well, that's gonna be a different affair. I really should change some things for Loomis. All the artillery deployed in the center of the line, so if they come through here, they will face quite a bit of fighting. The ground is mostly flat around here, by the looks of it. Nothing interesting going on right now. If you're playing the Confederates, this is a moment when you rush the enemy with all you have. Of course, right now they do outnumber me. There's 15,000, well, close to 15,000 Union soldiers, 17,000 Confederate soldiers. I'll just take the Iron Brigade and march it over here. Alright, the Napoleon guns that I have should be able to inflict serious damage if they do actually march up that road. This gives you a better idea of the elevation that you're dealing with, especially if you zoom in. There isn't really a whole lot, mainly here, sure. For now, Confederate forces are still arriving, and right now there's... And they're arriving from the south. There's about 30,000 of them deployed. I've got 15,000, so I'm on number 2-1. Well, just gonna wait for more of my army to deploy. Don't really have much choice over here how the deployment is affected. Okay, most of the Confederate army, I guess, is deployed. Yes, 50,000 Confederate troops have been deployed. There are 100,000 troops in the entire theater of operations, and I will deal with over half of them. Just gotta wait. Time has run out. Initial deployments have been made. Confederates are too many. We are outnumbered. Fall back, fall back. We must defend our camp or else our campaign will end prematurely. I think we've gotten some reinforcements. Yes. The rebels are attacking us. Return to defend the camp. I fall back, get that artillery there as well. I don't think they're... Okay, so here's the problem. It's tempting to try and follow through with these objectives. It is incredibly foolhardy to actually do so. Because the battle will not end even if you do capture said objectives. So it's a pointless affair to try and do so. I learned that the hard way, attempting to win this battle. You should be given the option of rushing. Like if you just, you know, take these two within the first day, then yeah, you should just win the battle. But no, that's not how this one works. It works at Gettysburg if you just rush through, right? Capture the cemetery. Quickly from, say, the Union, if you're playing the Confederates. It works in this battle if you're playing the Confederates. But it doesn't work if you're playing the Union. There is no easy battle over here. There is just a slaughter. Well then, I will endeavor to destroy Lee's armies in detail. As in, completely annihilate it. To the best of my ability. It won't really hurt them, though. Not in terms of the campaign. Still worth trying, right? Doing as much damage as possible. That's just really dumb. I mean, really, I wish I could deploy on the other side of the fence. Right, I'll take a brigade over here. Their other two will station themselves as a backline over on this side. No fighting so far, just deployment of troops. And there won't be any fighting until... And there won't be any advance on my part until I can do so. There are two Confederate corps on the field. There's only one of my corps on the field right now. Alright, that was the first day, no real fighting. Now, it begins. 60,000 versus... 60,000, really? Yeah, okay. They'll attack from the flanks. That's all I need to know. General, it seems that our plan is not progressing well. Oh, no, really. The Confederates responded very aggressively, and now we are on the defensive. Our camp in Chancellorsville must be secured if we want to advance further. Our brigades must be deployed to defend the east side of our camp and our left flank. The rebels are less likely to attack here, but we must be wary. They won't really attack over there. I mean, seriously, look at this entire deployment. That's ridiculous. I mean, this is kind of, I guess, what the typical military deployment look. A strong infantry presence at this area will protect us against a direct frontal attack from Lee. Our brigades also must be able to defend the ground around the camp and up to this section. Finally, some brigades must cover our far right. All right. Attempting to advance will not end very well for you. You'll just throw away a lot of troops that you do need for later. Alright, so I'm gonna redeploy my troops over here. I will be attacked on this front, and I really don't want to get stuck in this deployment zone. There's nothing worth defending over here. We have... I'll need to bring the artillery, all of it, to bear right in the middle. The enemy will attack. Send them in the tall grass. That should help them a bit. Deploy as much of the artillery as possible. Save. Yes, this is the kind of battle where you need to save just to be on the safe side. I'll leave a artillery battery over there. So it begins. Stonewall Jackson attacks our right. Rhodes Division spotted. Colston's Division spotted. AP Hill's Division spotted. Three entire Confederate divisions are marching on my right. As I knew they would. There's maneuver warfare, but this... yes, this is quite the bold move by General Lee. Fire! Alright, so the main battle is taking place right here. Everything else is just really a distraction. Alright, we're stuck in, so to speak. So, next day, 54,000 versus 48,000. We've done some damage, but not enough. I need to go. Well, we suffered one general loss. Good. We'll need to flank Jackson. Lee may assault full frontal. We are under heavy pressure. The Confederates assault our camp at Chancellorsville, and now we have to defend it at all costs. Stonewall Jackson's corps is the biggest threat. His forces will soon come out of the woods and charge at us. This hilly grove is a risky position to defend because if the rebels sight our cannon here, we will. Right? We might need to take it out, actually. Yeah, we will need to take these troops and all of these. It doesn't matter. They'll participate regardless. So, take all of my. Gotta take all of my cannons, mass them together on the left and in the center. I'll need to also take some of the Union. Right. Oh, this is bad. This is really fucking atrociously bad. I mean, I have one unit, but it's just laughably bad. Alright, take the Iron Brigade. This will be enough. These units will perform a flanking maneuver against Jackson's forces. The cannons here will stay where the hell they are. The cannons and skirmishers over here will advance. Thank you. Alright, the frontal assault, which isn't the main assault, it's clear, is not going anywhere. Their flank attack, their main assault, has been stopped and it's being pushed back slowly. But it is. I'm gonna take more units from the defense line here and throw them right into the meat grinder. And it is a meat grinder. I'm also gonna get my artillery a bit closer. Irvin McDowell has been killed, sadly enough. Oh well. Such is the nature of war. Not really something I can control, can I? Alright, the battle. Well, we just need to hold. We've done more, significantly more damage than we've taken. Sure, we've lost, what, 11,000 men? Doesn't quite matter. They've lost half their fucking army almost. So, charge in with the cavalry, take out their artillery. That's gonna be one of the main goals over here. Take out the damn artillery on that side. The other one, do as much damage as I can here. It's not even a question of holding, that's an afterthought, really. The line. Yep. The line has held. I'm gonna take woods and them over here on this side. Need to capture more supplies. Where's the third cavalry unit though? There we go. Loomis. Cavalry eliminated. Got to fall back with scales over there. They don't have much ammo left. Alright, most of the Confederate army has been thrown off the fucking field of battle over here. We're not done though. Far from it. I need to take my cavalry, flank around, and destroy the artillery that Jackson has. Then I'll be done. It's not about killing the infantry though over here. Also, I could certainly stand to recover some. These two will get. Move. Go. It's done. Alright. That's a victory. Yeah. I do still want to destroy that artillery. I guess 3 units. To hell with it, fine. I'll accept this particular outcome, even if I didn't eliminate all the artillery. We have a chance to advance. We do. We really do. Alright, 40... Well, Lee certainly had his reserves, didn't he? There's still 24,000 men left on this battlefield. Alright, the odds were against us, but we held. We held Chancellorsville. Our brave soldiers are exhausted, but so are those of the enemy. These army is expecting us behind these woods. His line expands to the northeast. Up to this forested area. I actually should have gone to camp and put some generals in place, but... You can now deploy the very best units that are still operational. What exactly is still operational in this situation? Like, really? We've taken a pounding. Not a small one, either. Still. Victory is within grasp. Right, nothing here. There are some units. I guess some artillery could do instead of throwing a bunch of, yeah, Sheridan. Poor Sheridan. Take Grant, he'll be useful here. Plenty of artillery, plenty of guns, plenty of units. Sherman in the center. We will throw 45, close to 45 units anyway, at the enemy and see what comes of it. I don't know where I'll win, to be honest. But I need to win. So, you can try and take these objectives, these two. The oranges, right at the start of the battle. But you will not win the battle. You will still need to fight the slugfest that I just did in order to actually win the battle. I do still have plenty of supplies, actually. So, yeah. Okay, let's see what comes of it. I don't know what to expect, really. I'll take the very best units, or rather the ones that are not bleeding to death. And advance on all sides. Alright, all that I need to do right now is just break these this formation right here. Throw them out of there, and that will be the battle. They have quite a few units that are not engaged, quite a few infantry that is. That's what I need right here. They'll break. They did. Alright, we'll pull back then. St. Carolyn right there. No field, actually. The best job. Well, Grant is dead. Damn it, old hell. Yeah, not gonna do that. I need to win Chancellorsville. Alright, 40,000 dead to 23,000. And now we have the Battle of Salem Church. 14,000 against 15,000. Alright, let's take these cores and advance. We need to hurry, take the church, hurry up and secure the crossroads. All right. Not an issue. Alright, 3rd and Light Divisions, troops incoming, plenty of troops incoming. Bring them all to bear, position them on the field. Good, 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 more units. Damn, skirmishers. Alright, they're routing. The church will soon be ours. Well, we've taken more casualties than they have, but that doesn't matter as long as the battle is won here. And there comes the surprise. The unpleasant one, that is. Yeah, I was wondering where the... some of the enemy units were. Gonna need to deploy more troops over here. Defeat. I mean, I took the church, damn it. Well, that's not good enough, obviously. All right, no need to Zerg rush it, I guess, this time around. I'll try again. See how it goes. Obviously, I intend to win. Alright, the church has fallen. Now it's a question of holding it. I'll flank the cannons over there. Hold on. Damn it all, stop, stop. Many of them. That does it a lot better, Freaker reports for T8 reputation. Fucking finally. Very good. We got clobbered. I think we have what, less than 30,000 men left. Right, go to camp then.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Well, there won't be any reinforcements, so there's no fourth core in this battle. There's just three cores of the Union Army against the Confederate one. Besides, we only have a couple, like Devon's troops, right, mounted troops, and Bedford. Alright then. Well, I guess I should renew the first corps, first and foremost.
Yes, sir.
Alright, I could spend 60 on the Spencer rifles and on the, you know, the coin. All that coin, all that juicy coin. We've taken substantial casualties, and replacing these guys with raw recruits is gonna be particularly painful. Anyway, I'm just looking at the first core. What do I need more? Yeah, I should just replace all those Lorenzes.
Yes, sir.
Plenty of Harper's Ferry this time around. Alright, gonna go with regular Springfields in this case. Alright, I figure that will do. Costin Sanyot.